everyone, let's just give a warm welcome to our panelists. Thank you everyone for being here. I mean, congratulations, Lee, on the film. The reaction out there in the world has been very strong so far, but there's a lot more to go ahead. I mean, how did this start? Where did this come from?
This is sort of the culmination of a 3-year journey. I was bullied as a kid, and as a filmmaker, I think you try and find stories that you can connect with, because it's a long haul to make a film, and I think it's, you know, when you can connect and do something that's really personal and meaningful, it matters so much. And for me, I think I wanted to make a film that gave a voice to you know, in a way, bullying sort of exists sometimes in this construct that's very hard to define. What is bullying? What is, you know, and it's often met with a response that can be minimizing, which is kids will be kids, and, you know, this is a rite of passage. And so I thought, first and foremost, I wanted to try and just show it and really, like, let people walk in these shoes and experience it. And then hopefully allow for the kinds of, I mean, this is exactly what I dreamed of when we started this movie, that we would be sitting and I would have an audience with the Minister of Education and youth leaders and educators. And, you know, this is exactly what I dreamed of. And so here we go, like, the conversation begins.
But I think that I hope the message that the audience leaves with is every single person has a role to play. And we have a role to play, whether it's in our community, whether it's talking to our kids, whether it's talking to our kids about not being bystanders. There were lots of bystanders in every community, in every part of this film. And in Ontario, for those that aren't following, we've made a lot of headway in terms of what we're doing in our schools. We are about on a 9-year journey right now, at safe schools, making sure our schools are inclusive to diversity issues. And we have a bill in front of the legislature right now, which is the Accepting Schools Act, to take it to the next level, to say it's not about tolerance, it's about acceptance and celebrating each other, and whether you're gay or straight, whether you have a disability, or whether whatever your religion is, you know, that legislation is part of a comprehensive strategy to say we all have a role to play. The school has a role to play, and we'll play our role. I'm a parent. In addition to the Minister of Education, I have a role to play as a parent. Our communities have roles to play, and our kids, all of us do. And I think that's the biggest message that I think will be the point of dialogue, you know, out of today, out of tonight. I think we're educating our educators to find that teachable moment in a hallway, and instead of letting it go by, say, Johnny, what just happened there? You know, don't you think that might... We need to teach our educators how to respond, and that's part of the work that we're doing, for example, bringing in a number of experts to help us look at the Ontario curriculum, to take it to the next step, to say, how do you teach our educators, our principals, ourselves, our bus drivers? Everybody has a role to play. The parents, from the time a child steps on the bus, when I put my two boys on the bus, I expect them to be safe on that bus. That's the beginning of the school day, and that's what we intend to deliver in Ontario.
Okay, well, I was bullied as a kid as well, and when the It Gets Better project really came out last year and I started learning about all these teen suicides, much like we saw in this film, it impacted me and made me realize that kids will just be kids is not something we can say. We can't justify that, and we can't justify bullying, and so I wanted to take a stand. And so I wrote to a bunch of influential people, including Lady Gaga, and she responded with a video, and that's how I'm here today, because of her video she sent to my school and the assembly we had. And I've gotten to speak at different schools and really raise awareness with kids all across Canada, and I've been to the States, just spreading this message that kids will be kids is not something we can say. We can't justify bullying, and we need to stop it now, and it's our job to make it better. So it will get better if we make it better.
These are not easy, simple conversations to have, whether we're a group of adult learners that we work with or the students in your school. It's about creating safe spaces to take this film further.
To me, what's really important is that as this film rolls out, that educators are our partners, that schools are our partners, that government agencies feel like they can partner with us. It's like such a critical piece of creating change. So Alex today I'm so happy to be able to share with you guys. It's doing so amazingly well. Like, you wouldn't recognize, like, the difference. It's like you can't even believe that this is the same kid from 2 years ago. And he flew to Los Angeles and argued against the R rating together with Harvey Weinstein to the MPAA appeals board, which is just amazing. Harvey said, "Lee, you're gonna sit this one out. I need Alex." And he killed it. I mean, we didn't win, but we lost by one vote. But he just, you know, he said, he basically in his sort of statement, he said, you know, what you're effectively saying is that I can't see my own life. And you know, I'm no expert on the MPAA, and there's lots of big issues. But I think that one thing I've realized is that there's a great hypocrisy in allowing films that glorify or even sort of sexify violence to get PG and PG-13 ratings time and time and time and time again. And then for them to bring down the hammer on a film like this on behalf of American family values, to me, just seems totally out of whack. And the kids in the film asked us to hold strong and fight this R. When I say that, like, it was really meaningful that Canada gave it a PG and in Quebec a G, it was, of course, right? I did do my first drinking in Montreal. So, look, you know, I can tell you that in the midst of the battle, we would get calls from our team here in Canada, and they would say, "You're not going to believe this, but BC just gave us a PG," and like we would just cheer because it gave us the strength to keep fighting. So, you know, I'm very grateful for their judgment and the process that they, the consideration and thought that they gave to this film. And, you know, we're doing everything that we can to make it relevant and build really powerful partnerships and tools and resources around it so that when this dream of seeing whole schools sign on to go see this film, that I know it's going to be meaningful, that they're going to, you know, sign a contract that says that they're going to use this curriculum, that they're going to engage with youth partnerships, that it's going to be a whole community contract that includes students and teachers and cafeteria staff and bus drivers and administrators and school board members and parents. That's awesome. And
hi, I'm a grade 8 student at East Alternative School, and it's a really small school. There are 3 teachers, 32 kids in my class, and that's the only grade 8 class. And what we have done as a school is try to stand up and stop bullying. And one of the things that we have done is every week, everyone in the school for 45 minutes comes and sits down in a full school circle, and we talk about issues, and they're not always bullying, but they very often are, and if something comes up, it gets stopped there and then. And at the start of the school, you get to hear everyone's stories. Most people are crying. It is very sad because people come here because they've been bullied in so many different ways in so many different places. But another thing we do, which I think is even more powerful, is we don't call a bystander a bystander. In Canada, if you see a theft or a murder, you are called a witness, and it is a crime if you do not report it. In our school, you are called a witness. You are responsible for stopping it and reporting it. And we are, our goal and what we've started to do now is we sort of have a little play and a little shadow dance, which is at the start of the year you make a mask and you basically talk about your feelings. And we've gone around to other schools and presented this and done a full school circle there and tried to spread the message to stop bullying. So basically my question is, what do you think should be the next step from here? What do you want to see happen?
You know, certainly congratulations to all of you guys. And I think if I can leave one message with the audience, I have the privilege to travel around and see all of our schools in Ontario. And every time I go into a school, I hear from our students and what they are doing, whether it's in ESA, whether it's in an elementary school, whether it's in the north, in the south. The kids really get it.
That is just an amazing initiative that your school has and that you folks take part in, and those types of conversations need to happen in schools all over the place, let's face it. And other conversations need to happen around language as well. I have to sort of second what you were saying about language and your use of the word witness. There's language around bullying that sort of minimizes bullying sometimes for people who are not inside this room. And I think sometimes we can parcel bullying out into what it actually is. And what it actually is assault, and what it actually is harassment, and what it actually is intimidation. And it's very, very strong language that sometimes gets drowned out in the word bullying, which we sort of see as, some people see as sort of just a schoolyard thing. So I think the use of language to sort of expand what bullying actually is and make it a little bit more factual. I mean, forgive the example, but if I turned around and I hit Lee, nobody would say I bullied him. They'd say I assaulted him. And I think that's the kind of language that somebody
And I could get a restraining order in like 10 minutes, right?
Let's call it what it is.
I'm more hopeful than anything else right now. I think that the narrative has been tragedy for the last 2 years. And I think people are stepping up and people are sick of it. And I think a lot of this generation is saying, we don't want this to be our story anymore. We can actually step up. We can be the generation that turns the tide on this. And I have a lot of hope. And I see leadership everywhere, in all quarters. And it's so inspiring. And to the extent that this film and other initiatives can be part of that conversation, it's fantastic. But I really believe that this is the moment where, like other ills in our society that we've sort of laid slowly to rest, that this is the moment for bullying, and the turning point is now.
And one interesting phenomenon we keep bumping into is students obviously are desperate to hear this message. They're very relieved to hear it. Teachers are foaming at the mouth to hear this message that you're saying today. Principals, not every time, but are often feel the same way. But it seems like as soon as we get to the board level, something happens. This is a strange invisible hand that seems to put the kibosh on it, and we can't seem to figure out how to get around this. I don't know what it is, I don't know if anybody can speak to this, but it seems like as soon as we get to the board level, there's this nervousness, and so I'm just curious if you could maybe shed some light on whose feet we have to hold to the fire, and who we all have to point at to sort of loosen the grip a little bit and let them hear this pro-LGBT message in schools. What are your thoughts?
So I'll start. You need to call your MPP and get Bill 13 passed. Bill 13 is a piece of legislation which specifically says we need student-led clubs like a Gay-Straight Alliance or many of the student initiatives that we have. It will be required in all of our schools, and every single school in Ontario will be required to adhere to it because the Accepting Schools Act amends Ontario's Education Act. So we put it in the act that governs the entire school system in Ontario, that we will define bullying, that we will respond to bullying, how it will happen, and we specifically identify LGBTQ issues and tackling that issue specifically in our schools. And Bill 13 is going to be a critical component to make sure that we move that forward. So call your MPP, get them to vote for Bill 13. We don't have a majority government here in Ontario. And so we're looking for support from all of our colleagues, and I think it's going to be a great issue, and hopefully the House can come together on it.
Can I also add that to go along with the study guide, and I think this is really important, is that the idea is that we've developed a webinar for teachers that will be launched in the next couple of weeks, so that it's not only about downloading the study guide, which is, I think, critical for everybody to do, but that for teachers who are bringing their kids to movies, the idea is that each of those teachers will participate in the webinar online course so that it's accessible to everybody. So that's in connection, and I think goes hand in hand with a lot of what you're saying.
But the challenges that schools, not only in my board, but in other boards are facing is there's a lack of time to teach kids about character education because there's this large emphasis on EQAO scores and other things like that, and math and language seem to take precedent over important issues like teaching kids empathy.
I remember going to all the bullying assemblies at my school and hearing teachers talk about how we need to treat each other better, and you all just stop paying attention and you don't take anything from that. And so at our school, when we had our assembly, we were looking at what we could do to make it different. And what made looking at bullying different for me was looking at all these teen suicides, and that's something that deeply impacted me. And so we talked about that, and we had a memorial for 30 students that have committed suicide, and then it played, and it had students at our school in tears. And after our assembly, as each student was leaving, we gave them a rubber wristband that said, "I will make it better" on it. We had each kid take a pledge at the assembly and a written pledge, which we then created a mural that said ESA, the name of our school, and with using their pledges. So I think as much as having an empathy counselor or a teacher that teaches that course, what worries me about that is that the kids would just start looking at it and not paying attention again. Like, no offense to any like careers teachers in here, but careers is a course that students don't look at as a serious course, and they take the time to not pay attention, or they do their math homework during careers class. And so if we have a class like that, what worries me, is, as ridiculous as that sounds, is that kids aren't going to start paying attention. So I think what's great about this film, again, and great, it's raising awareness that kids need to talk to kids. Mm. And the more students contribute and the more students stand up, I think, in this issue with bullying, which is from one student to another, to fix that problem, we need to go from one student to another.
Because this really is a moment where the kids really care about this, and Jacques is a hit wherever he goes. Look at him. I mean, he's doing quite well. I hate to cut it off. We only have time for one more question, though. So if we could go over here.
I hope it's a good one, then. the one scene in the film where Ty Smalley's father's on Facebook, using that to get people to come to the rallies and all that. I think it's great that people are using Facebook and the internet for support groups and campaigns and stuff, but there are a lot of bad things and a lot of opportunity for worse bullying that doesn't end when the kids go to home from school. And how, you know, you're trying your best and you're saying, you know, you have two sons, Laurel, and when they go on the bus, you want them to be safe till they come home. But after that, how big of a challenge is that? And what can you even do to stop? And especially, I think, maybe even this is being taken advantage of by girl bullies a lot, I think, online and using internet to, on the weekends after school and summer holidays, like it just doesn't end. So what can be done? What kind of jurisdiction is there for schools?
Sure. When it comes to that? We consider cyberbullying between students in a school within the realm of responsibility in terms of a principal being able to, if they hear about it, to say, well, your conduct on the cyber world is making it unsafe for this other student to come to school, or you're negatively affecting them. We consider that an area where our schools can take responsibility. We know that for many parents, my guys are only 6 years old, but you know, for many parents of older kids, we've seen a lot of parents' council look for money from the Ministry of Education to host cyberbullying, internet safety, different events, and we've funded that and brought in some experts so that they can have the conversation about what's happening on Facebook, what's happening on, you know, that whole cyber world. And we are clearly defining within the bill that's in front of the House right now that cyberbullying is part of the problem in our schools. It is not going to be for us exclusively to tackle in our schools, but we have a role to play, as do parents and as do providers in terms of the rest of, you know, the internet world. There is no doubt that you used to be able to go home, the kids in the show could go home, close the door, the bullies were on the other side. Now the bullies follow you home, to your phone, into your bedroom, into your safe space. And it is a serious issue, and we need to talk about that and tackle that as well.
Before we close, I was just wondering if you guys, could we get a sign of hands of the educators in the room tonight? Wow. It's like about half the room. That's awesome. Thank you, guys. And can I also just see a sign of hands of everyone that's under 18 that's in the room tonight? All right. Okay. Well, this is a perfect room for a really powerful conversation. I want to thank. I know you're gonna send us all out of here, but I just want to thank you guys for coming out tonight and sharing our Toronto premiere and having a wonderful and really powerful conversation. Thank you all so much.